So why are some Azure APIs in the Azure namespace and others are in the Microsoft namespace? Well, some of this has to do with the history of the Azure SDK and the Azure SDKs. Originally, when Azure came on board, teams would write their own SDK, and they would, following the guidelines of the time, would write their APIs in the Microsoft namespace because they're Microsoft services. And part of the challenges we had was that there weren't a lot of consistent rules about how you interact with services. And every service kind of invented their own rules about how they thought things should be interpreted. And as a consequence, it was a little bit of the Wild West back in the day. And at some point, several years ago, some folks over in the Azure SDK team said, you know what, hold on. We need to follow the guidelines. We need to come up with guidelines for what it is that an Azure SDK looks like. And following the lead of the .NET team and the Windows team, they came up with a set of guidelines that are, what are the guidelines for making an Azure service? How do the APIs look like? How does every constructor look like? How do you interact with services? How do you build asynchronous APIs, synchronous APIs? Are there any synchronous APIs? Are there any asynchronous APIs? And there are examples of SDKs that are only asynchronous or only synchronous. All of those are codified in the guidelines, and the types for these new SDKs are all in the Azure namespace because they reflect that they are written under the guidelines that the Azure team has developed for writing SDKs and writing APIs that talk to Azure services.